beautiful people, trust this means you well. So today is day 8 of Vlogmas, and I know that in day 7 I actually talked about, you know, gave you updates of my week, and I also did mention that here in Nigeria, you know, we really are not yet in the mood of Christmas because it's just a Nigerian thing, okay? So today I actually would like to give you a heads up about, you know, what Decembers are like in Nigeria. Now, I mean, this could serve more like a reminder for those who are Nigerians but no longer in Nigeria, the things you used to know about, and also not to scare anyone, but also to update you, inform you on how Decembers are like in Nigeria. And I am trusting that you'll find this helpful in case you are thinking of coming into Nigeria, the things to look out for, the things to be careful about, the things to be very much alert about. Okay, so that's basically the content of today. And remember, if you're returning, thank you for coming back again. And if this is your first time of stopping by, welcome. This is Lifestyle Genius Versatile, where I share with you lifestyle tips, share experiences with you from the perspective of a single parent. Okay, so let's delve right into it without further ado. All right, number one, essentially, once it is the Ember month. Now, when you hear Ember month in Nigeria, what we're talking about, so it's not new to you, it's not strange to you, what we're talking about is September, October, November, December. Okay, makes sense, right? So once you hear Ember month, basically that's a period for you to be alert. That's a time for you to be smart. Street smartness have to be like top notch, because you need all the street smarts knowledge you might know to be able to go by. That's like the season when bad people, you have the 419ers. 419ers are like scammers, you know, they like up their game and are, you know, very intense in trying to get victims. You have what we call one chance. One chance is also a time when, I mean, a situation whereby you get into a vehicle. That's actually where the literal name came up from. A vehicle that is just one chance, but they have ulterior motives. Either they have intentions to kidnap or to maim or to steal from you or to rob you totally, you know, and maybe rob, steal, rape, you know, do all of the vices on that person. So that's a period you have to be careful. It's also a time when ritualists are like on the rise, on the increase, you know, and the kind of vehicles you take, the places you go to, the people you go to see. It's more like a time when ritualists are like trying to, well, we believe so much in rituals and ritualism in this part. So that's like the time when the ritualists come out in their numbers and are looking for victims. Most times virgins are like the main targets. And other times, pregnant people, other times you have mad people, sorry, people who are insane, you know, roaming the streets and all that. And children are like a high target too, because they would want to kidnap these children and use them for money rituals. So parents, you have to be careful. In case you've forgotten, it's still happening very much so. Also, you want to be very careful. Right now, due to technology, there's not been like another format for scamming people of their money or having people pathways with their money, using the banks, using the ATM fraud, using the cybercrime frauds. There are so much, okay? And like I said, I'm not saying this to scare you, I'm just saying this to inform you and remind you. Now, early on today, I had a friend recount on her experience that she had just yesterday, where she almost got not only robbed, although she said the intention of the cab guy she boarded was to steal from her, but apparently the guy had some jazz is like he had some voodoo, okay? So yeah, jazz is what we call voodoo in this part. So he had some jazz, and then he had this ring on, and then did it to her face, and, you know, was commanding her, but she had to use the spiritual means and like the blood of Jesus kind of thing, and it really didn't get to her. But there are lots of people who have fallen victim of this, so you want to be careful in this season. Another thing you also need to be careful about is when you go to the markets, like when you go to the local markets. Now, I know that at the supermarkets, they are like, the price tags are already on it, so you don't necessarily have to bargain. But when you go to the market, you also want to be sharp, you want to be smart about it, and price, you want to negotiate. That's what we call pricing. So you want to negotiate on the deals you're buying, because sometimes they see unassuming people and then they just boom, give you a price, and they take it like you really don't care, and, you know, that could be an opportunity to steal from you, to have you part ways with your money. You want to be careful there, okay? What else? Yes, accidents are on the rise, are on the high during this period of December, and that's mostly because you have a large number of people driving. Some are going eastward, some are going northward, some are going westward, some are going southward. Whatever the case might be, wherever you're going, everybody is more like in a hurry in the period of December leading on to Christmas, the new year. You also want to be double careful. If you're a driver, you want to drive safely. You want to drive safely, of course, by making use of your seat belts, using all the safety measures while driving. And also, you do not want to drink and drive. You don't want to have distractions whatsoever. And I would also like to appeal to everyone who is traveling in the spirit of Christmas. If possible, apply the safety measures by not traveling as a family. So if you're a family of five, do well to divide yourselves and take turns in traveling, because you never can tell. And most times you might be pretty much careful while you drive, but the next person who's driving on the lane next to you might not be as careful. The person who's crossing the road might not be as careful. The bike guy who's also using his bike and being so rough might not be as careful, because you know, all our destinations are not the same. We have different destinations, right? So you want to be careful about that. Another thing you want to be careful about, well, I'm like I said, and I'll remind you again, I do not intend to scare you. Another thing you want to be careful about is what you eat, where you eat. Now, there's going to be a lot of festivities in the period of this December. You go to a place, everyone is cooking. Now, you must understand that if you have a type of, if you have a very sensitive stomach, you want to be careful where you eat from, the things you eat, because of course, different people use different things to cook. So while you're eating, be careful for food poisoning. Okay, I think I have pretty much covered it. And while you are looking and being very happy celebrating with everyone and celebrating Christmas, it's always good to look out for yourself. And likewise, try not to overwhelm yourself, because your mental health is key. Need I say that again? Your mental health is key. So while you're trying to stay in good spirits and be cheerful, you know, be merry and all of that, try as much as possible to take a step back, rest in between, take enough rest if you must. After all, it's a period of the holiday. I know some people would also be working still, but find time to rest amidst the enjoyment, amidst the, you know, flexings and all of that. Find time to rest, please, and take care of yourself, because honestly, January is just going to come in like that, and then you resume work almost immediately. And you know, COVID has taken like the best part of the year, so you really want to start up really early in 2021. Well, I hope that these have been helpful for you. If you're a tourist coming into Nigeria in this period or years from now, I hope that these tips are very helpful for you in order to stay safe and out of trouble and out of harm's way whenever you visit Nigeria, Africa, and even wherever you are, because you never can tell, there are evil people all over the place. Not that we're looking out for evil people, but we also want to protect ourselves and our loved ones. Please keep your children safe. Protect them if you guys go to public places. Make sure they are aware where you're going to be, where they're going to meet up with you, or where you meet up with them. Please, 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 and please, we cannot stress further or stress enough how evil the days are. But let us stay safe, and I am wishing you the very best of the season. For now, it is love and light. I'll see you on day 9. Peace.